Welcome to Margie's initiative of Newspaper Simplified. Albert Einstein once famously said that in the midst of every crisis lies great opportunity. Means in Marathi we can say that apatti madhech tila ishtapatti karnyachi sandhi aste. Albert Einstein, in the midst of every crisis lies great opportunity. Prime Minister 10 point agenda for disaster risk reduction. There is one point in that 10 point. That is, ensure that opportunity to learn from the disaster must not be wasted. What it shows is that in every disaster, we must learn something from it. In today's Newspaper Simplified, we will discuss one news article in today's Mint. That is, lessons from India's trust with the lockdown. The harsh fact is India still not adequately prepared to tackle future disaster. There is one long story in today's Mint. The whole page is covered in this article, written by Bibek Debroy. You must be aware of his name, Bibek Debroy, Chairman, Economic Advisory Council to the PM. Where we can relate our today's discussion to the syllabus is that it is related to GS2, governance and government policy related issues. In GS3, we can relate it to disaster management. In article, there are significant positive that is shown related to India's fighting of COVID-19. One is that compilation brought out by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. There is one compilation brought out by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs on how smart cities responded to the pandemic. It shows that Agartala has 183 women SHG groups that produce masks under Dindayal Antyodaya Yojana. Dindayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Livelihood Mission link with SHG is there. So in Agartala, 183 SHGs produced masks. In Bareilly, there was community kitchen that was working. Also, role played by civil society was very significant in this context. You must be aware that one mercy mission was done in Bengaluru, in which 20 non-governmental organizations come together and they work for the overall coordination and betterment of vulnerable sections. What it shows that one eminent authority or one eminent thinker, Robert Putnam, said about this non-governmental organization, this non-governmental institutions that work in our society, he called them as a social capital. In a one way, this pandemic shows that when you have very well developed social capital, it will be beneficial to all of us. But Bibek Debroy in this article state that more systematic use or more systematic efforts need to be done to channelize or to streamline these efforts. Means what? Government do not have adequate information about these organizations. Government should done adequate mapping related to these organizations. SHG's role should be diversified. Means you must be aware that out of 1 crore SHGs that are present in India, as per NABARD, 90% SHGs are that of women members only. Means if we can channelize them well, it will lead to women empowerment also. But when we see the functioning of women SHG, their role is confined to specific areas. So if we diversify their roles, it will lead to better employment opportunity to them also. It will get better income in return also. Moving further, the article states that rural India was relatively insulated from both COVID and lockdown. It also states rural India benefited more from public welfare schemes. How rural India benefited more from public welfare schemes? Because socio-economic consensus, that is SCCC, rural is more robust than SCCC urban. The socio-economic consensus is conducted more robustly in the rural areas than the urban areas. You must be aware that 2021 is the year of census, so census related questions may come in a prelim as well as mains. So you must be thoroughly prepared about socio-economic consensus, the history of census and all related issues. One significant issue in urban areas is that there was no identification of migrants. Identification requirement under Interstate Migrants Worker एक्ट 1979, आइडेंटिफिकेशन रिक्वायरमेंट अंडर इंटर स्टेट माइग्रंट वर्कमैन एक्ट 1979 वॉज नेवर इम्प्लीमेंटेड. दिस एक्ट इज ऑल्सो सिग्निफिकंट, इंटर स्टेट माइग्रंट वर्कर एक्ट 1973. अंडर सिलेबस ऑफ GS3 देर इज वन पॉइंट, मैकेनिज्म लॉज इंस्टीट्यूशंस बॉडीज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड फॉर द प्रोटेक्शन एंड बेटरमेंट ऑफ वल्नरेबल सेक्शंस. मैकेनिज्म लॉज स्पेसिफिक मेंशन ऑफ लॉज फॉर बेटरमेंट ऑफ वल्नरेबल सेक्शंस. UPSC कैन डायरेक्टली आस्क द प्रोविजन्स व्हाट आर द चैलेंजेस और शॉर्टकमिंग ऑफ दिस एक्ट. सो व्हाट इट शोज दैट इफ गवर्नमेंट हैव रिक्वायर्ड डाटा, इफ हैव क्लियर कट नंबर दैट दीज आर द वल्नरेबल पॉपुलेशन, इट हेल्प इन सच अ पैंडेमिक कंडीशंस और डिजास्टर कंडीशंस विच आर मोर प्रेजेंट इन अ रूरल एरिया बिकॉज ऑफ सोशो इकोनॉमिक कॉन्सेंसस बट नॉट प्रेजेंट इन अर्बन एरियाज. द ओवरऑल थ्रस्ट ऑफ दिस आर्टिकल इज लीगल एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल फ्रेमवर्क. वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम द पॉलिसी परस्पेक्टिव वॉट वेंट रॉन्ग इन मैनेजमेंट ऑफ COVID-19. वन इशू इज दैट गवर्नमेंट यूज डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट एक्ट 2005. डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट एक्ट 2005 वॉज यूज एंड COVID-19 वॉज डिक्लेयर्ड नोटिफाइड डिजास्टर अंडर दिस एक्ट. यू मस्ट बी अवेयर दैट हेल्थ एज अ सब्जेक्ट इज इन लिस्टेड इन द स्टेट लिस्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. सो वन इशू इज दैट रिगार्डिंग द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन और रिगार्डिंग द इन्फोर्समेंट ऑफ वेरियस notifications under the Disaster Management Act is that health is not under the ambit of center. Then you must be aware that disaster as a subject is not mentioned in any of the list of the constitution, that is union list, state list or concurrent list. Disaster as a subject is not mentioned in any list. Then under which basis or under which power government enacted this law, Disaster Management Act 2005, the report of Rajya Sabha Standing Committee tells us that legislation of Disaster Management Act 2005 is relatable to Entry 23 in, that is, Social Security and Social Insurance. Entry 23, Social Security and Social Insurance in the concurrent list. In concurrent list there is Entry 23, that is Social Security and Social Insurance. Rajya Sabha report tells us that on the basis of this entry, the Act Disaster Management Act 2005 was enacted. So it shows that it is not directly related to disaster, it is a wider term used for enacting this act. What second ARC tells us that, report of second ARC tells that disaster management requires vertical and horizontal linkages. Vertical and horizontal linkages are required in disaster management. It involves coordination between union and state and local government, as well as between various government organizations, various government departments. Such coordination, such a kind of linkages required broadly uniform institutional framework. Broad uniform institutional framework is required, which is not possible in current situation. What ARC recommend and further states that we need disaster to be included in the concurrent list of the constitution. Going further, if we see the definition of disaster in Disaster Management Act 2005, we get idea that categorically it does not include epidemics in its definition. If we see the definition of disaster in Disaster Management Act 2005, categorically it does not include epidemics in its ambit. So it suggests that the act was not originally meant to deal with the epidemics. So that this is another issue. Health issues or health concern was not related to this act. Moving further, power bestowed by the Disaster Management Act on central and state government are very wide and extensive. Power bestowed by Disaster Management Act on the central government and National Disaster Management Authority are very extensive. Why extensive? Central government, irrespective of any laws in the force, can issue any direction to any authority anywhere in India to facilitate or assist the notification issued by them. So it shows that central government have extensive power in the act. 2020 UPSC asked one question in GS2, that is, Indian constitution exhibits centralizing tendency. Indian constitution exhibits centralizing tendency to maintain unity and integrity of the nation, elucidate the in the perspective of Epidemics Act 1897, Disaster Management Act 2005, and recently Farms Farm Act. So the UPSC asks the question from the perspective of federalism, Disaster Management Act, how it leads to centralizing tendency. One reason for that is that central government gets overriding power over all the other laws. Then there is another issue in Disaster Management Act, that is Section 71 of the Act. Section 71 of the Disaster Management Act bar jurisdiction of the court, means action of the national, state as well as district administrative authority cannot be challenged except in Supreme Court and High Court. No person can go in any other court except Supreme Court and High Court challenging the various provisions in the Act or its related to its implementation. When we see what we see in the witness in the COVID-19 is that various kind of discrimination happened, various kind of police excesses were reported from the various part of the country, but as it bar jurisdiction of the court, it will lead to the excessive burden on the higher judiciary, that is Supreme Court and High Court. Also, Disaster Management Act lack grievance redressal mechanism. No grievance redressal mechanism is there under the Act. At the policy level, we must understand one more significant issue, that is labeling the pandemic. How government labeled the pandemic, how government used terms that lead to the confusion or that lead to the existing prejudices, that we will see now. Government used word disaster instead of health crisis. Also, various government officials, various government functionaries titled it as a war against COVID-19. Instead of looking at it as a health crisis, they talked about war against COVID-19. Also, the word social distancing was used. What this all lead is to that stigmatization of not only that disease, COVID-19, but also the people susceptible or that got infected to that that disease. Such a kind of thing is also reported in case of HIV/AIDS. When such kind of stigmatization happened, people don't come to the hospital and further issues happen. So this not only lead to stigmatization, this also lead to the strengthening of social prejudices. So while formulating government policies, when government is issuing any statement, existing social conditions, existing social prejudices should be considered, and words or the concept title of any issue should be given in that manner. Moving further, one issue that must be addressed is that strengthening of local bodies. Under Disaster Management Act 2005, there have to be national plan, state plan and district plans. What is the requirement under Disaster Management Act 2005 is that there has to be national plan, state plan and district plan to handle disaster. But most of the district have not yet come up with the district level plan. So that is the issue. Also, national and state level policy, when taken in consideration with disaster, if have to be effective, the local level implementation, ground level implementation play clear key role. Such a ground level implementation will not be effective unless and until local government bodies, that is panchayat or district level bodies, are not administratively, politically and financially empowered. So these are the some key policy related things that we can learn from this COVID-19 pandemic and strategize our policy or think in the long term perspective regarding this. One is the constitutional and legal framework that is needed. We must ensure that 7th schedule is modified or amended in that perspective. So that is today, that is all from the today's discussion. Thank you. Thank you very much.